What's up guys, this is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure that you leave a like and subscribe for more video content. In this video, I will be addressing a issue or a problem with one of my older videos. I think it was video number 48, okay? And when I did that video, I was using QGIS 3.0 or something up in there, like 2.8 or something like that. It was a while back. It was like in 2018 or the beginning of 19, something like that. But anyway, in that video, I was showing or detailing how to fix a common problem when it came to buffering. Okay, so usually when we go to the buffer, we go to vector, we pull down to geoprocessing tools and go to the buffer. And in here, we will see this nice little yellow triangle, which is a warning sign. It's telling us something is wrong. Maybe not catastrophically wrong, where if we do it, it will cause a crash, but wrong enough where, look, there is something else that you could do to manipulate this. Okay, so with this little box, what we're going to do in this video, I'm going to show you some solutions to get this buffer by degrees to be an adjustable unit. So let's go ahead and get started. I'll exit that. And out here, I brought in some points. Okay, and in this point layer, if I double click on it and I look in the information tab, we see that this is a CRS WGS84. We see the extent and we see the units, which are degrees. And this is what we want to change. All right, so we can exit out of that. And to change this, we will pan over our layer, right click, and we will scroll down to set CRS. We'll click that. And when we get to set CRS, what we want to do in here, or actually let me show you around first. There's a little preview down here, which is kind of like a heat map, or like a heat map, and it's showing you all the area that will be covered by a specific CRS extent. All right, so there are many extents out here. You can click on any of them. It'll just change and show you what it is covering. Okay, but what we want to get to is meters. Okay, so we want something with some meters. And if we look in the little code down here or the description, we can see what kind of units these things are measured in. But just because it says link unit meter doesn't mean that it's covering the extent that we need. Right now, this is not the extent that we need. We want to see the whole world, okay? Like a global extent. And so let's go ahead. Well, actually, before I do that, in this filter, you can look for different keywords, locations, and even units. Now, the main units that you can look for in this filter are feet, meters, and degrees. Okay, so if I were to type in feet here, you'll see down here I will get many choices of feet. Okay, feet. If I type in here meters, or actually let's do degree first, degree, and I pressed enter for some reason. Now if you happen to press enter, what'll happen is you won't see your points anymore. And that is not good, right? But you can just come back in here and change it right back to where it was. But in this case, I'm not going to change it back to where it was. I want to actually change the CRS. Actually, I'll go ahead and, yeah. This is where it was, WGS84. And if I hit OK again, you see that my points reappear. But let's go ahead and finish with this box. So I was looking for degrees. Okay, and there is a bunch of options on degrees. You can get whatever kind of degrees that you want to, or whatever extent of degree that you want to use. Now, to select this, you can double click and it'll automatically close this dialog box and apply this CRS to the layer, or you can click OK, or you can click Enter. Any of those will apply. All right, but we want an extent that covers the globe. So let's do a Mercator. And these are some of the ones that I was looking at recently. And so this Mercator covers the entire extent. Now we need to make sure that the length unit is in meters. So it is measured by meters, okay? Now you can scroll down here. You may see like angle unit, degree, and a couple of other things. But what you want to do is make sure that your length unit is in the desired unit. All right, so let's go ahead and double click, and that'll make that happen. And now it looks as if there is 1 point here. But what has happened is with the CRS being changed and recalculated, the features are centered. They're centered into the middle, and basically the scale has been changed a little bit. So let's go ahead and double click on this point layer again. And now we see that it has a new CRS. This CRS is WGS84 pseudo Mercator, and it is in meters. Now, if we zoom in a lot, zoom in, we will begin to see our points come back in. Okay. So let's go ahead and make that buffer that we were talking about earlier, or actually go to the buffer. We'll go to the Geoprocessing Tools buffer. And now with this distance, that yellow triangle has left the scene. And we now have adjustable units here. Okay, now you need to remember that this map is measuring by meters now. So if you were to make a buffer of 10, this would be a huge buffer because we are measuring by meters. So what you would do is just decrease this to maybe like 1 meter. And I'll go ahead and run this just to show you that it works. And that's 1 meter out. And I'll go ahead and zoom back a little bit. And I'll put my points back on top of the buffer here, so you can actually see the individual points and the buffers that were created for them. Okay, now one more thing that you can do to make this happen, or to change the CRS from the beginning before you even create these layers, is you can go up here to Project, and you can go to Project Properties, and there is a CRS tab where you can type in that pseudo Mercator as your project CRS, and you can apply that, and now every layer that you create will be able to have that CRS. So let me show you. If you create a scratch layer here, let's say whatever scratch layer, let's say points, and in this little drop down box you have several options here. Now the project CRS is here, and this is what we want. The default, if you wanted to go back to the default, you could do that as well. But if you were doing it, now that is with a temporary scratch layer. It is the same with adding or creating, or yeah, just creating a shapefile layer. So if I was creating a shapefile layer, I would still be able to get to my project CRS, and I will make sure that is clicked, so when it is created, we get that, and we don't have to go back into the layer. The other thing with manipulating the CRS of the project is that if you have layers out here that have not been changed, so if I double click on the line layer, it is still in degrees, and it will not show up until it is changed to the project CRS. And the way you do that is the same way that we did it at first. Go back to set CRS and do it that way. You can also change the project CRS by going into the into the layer that has been changed to what you want or has the CRS that you want, and you can right click, go to set CRS, and go to set project CRS from this layer. Okay, so let's say you bring in a layer that has its own CRS and you already have files in here, but you want to change that project CRS without going to project and properties and all that. You just right click, set CRS, and set project CRS from this layer. All right, so guys, I hope this cleared up some of the problems and issues that you are having with the video 48. I will be linking those two videos. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. I will get to them as soon and as fast as possible. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.